That time of the day, baby. Welcome to New York, we are live. My name is Jens Galani. Please don't forget to subscribe. Boy, do I got a show for you today. Remember this? I even forgot the words. Hang on in front. That's how old this is. Earth, wind, and fire. There's a reason why I picked this song. Welcome to New York Real Live. My name is Jens Giordani, and today we have a very special show. And boy, it's getting hot, man. It's getting hot. So how y'all doing, man? How you guys dealing with this alleged? Let me keep it like that, right? Alleged election fraud. Hey, listen, man. It is what it is. I mean, we can't act like there's some among us that don't know about that. It happens. And it's been going on for quite some time. And it seems like these socialist Democrats are not afraid to take a chance. This can be considered, if you get caught, man, you can do up to 10 years in prison if you get caught cheating in an election. It's almost like close to treason, you ask me. But hey, listen, the mainstream media already calling Joe Biden the president-elect, and he's damn near picked the whole cabinet already. He's ready to move in, ready to go, you know. And I just found out today that four people from his cabinet are lobbyists for the China regime. Oh yeah. So it's gonna get interesting. The Trump team, I don't know if you guys know, but Trump has the what I call the dream team of attorneys. You know, headed by Giuliani, the greatest mayor New York that has ever had, so some say, especially during the 9/11 situation, which is a topic that I want to talk to you guys one of these days. It's just that this is not the time right now. I want to talk to you about something that is like really, really bugging me out, yo, because I'm not going to front. this information that I'm going to be sharing with you guys, I haven't been able to cross fact checked. Cross fact checked. Excuse me. But I do have a source. I do have a real good source. Yeah, I'm sorry. I got to maintain it anonymous. Ah, well, then maybe not. I want to send a shout out to my brother, Hector Rodriguez, that he just had an operation on his right leg, and he's beginning to heal. Unfortunately, for the hospital, maybe not for him, but, well, yeah, maybe for him too, because, you know, there's really no money in the world that can, you know, buy health, if you ask me. But unfortunately for the hospital, I think they really messed up. You know, they went to do something on his leg. I don't really want to get into detail because it's really personal to him. But they went to do an operation on his leg and they ended up messing up his knee. I mean, the man cannot bend his knee at all. But Hector Rodriguez, he's not only one of my best friends, but he's also my partner, researcher. And he was one of the first guys that came across this particular story that I want to talk to you about. Now, as you, a lot of people know already, oh, before I forget, I want to send a shout out to Hey Hey Swing Combo and all the guys that participated in my show, my CD release party at Tito Santos El San Juan restaurant / lounge in Spanish Harlem. I want to send a shout out to them, to Gil, to Adriel, Eric, Mike Perez, head of a piano player, and all the rest of the guys. I also want to send a shout out to my daughter, Melinda, that is at Syracuse the last time I checked, because she hasn't been calling lately, you know. So she must be like really, really busy. You know, I'm going to have to take the initiative, I guess, and give her a ring. But anyway, Hector found some information that I was trying to cross fact check. And it's like very, very difficult because they're trying to keep this like really hush hush. But here it is. I'm going to bring it to you guys. Sometime this past Saturday, Joe Biden allegedly got hurt. His ankle or something with his ankle or his foot playing with his dog. You know, the first question that I asked myself was, what a man his age doing playing with a very healthy, athletic dog, right? But, you know, who am I? Because he's, you know, Joe is like really up there. I believe he's in the mid-70s. You know, and I think he should have taken care. I mean, that's exactly what happened. Because you have to understand, they held that news back a full day. And not only it was reported the following day, but it was reported sparingly. I mean, very little. No details. He broke his foot. He was playing with the dog. End of the story. Now, let me just say this. The last time I checked, there was a guy, may he rest in peace, a senator by the name of McCain. I'm sure you guys, a lot of you guys remember him, right? From Arizona. Not a fan of Trump, of course. I don't think Trump was a big fan of his either. But somehow, some way, he was either skiing or something happened that he broke his foot. And he had one of those boots, right? Now, it turned out that sometime within that same week, Hillary Clinton had issues with her foot as well and had one of those same boots that Biden is wearing right now. Now, me and Hector, we got deep into this story. You know, we got deep. I got my computer. He got his computer. And we went all over the website. We even went into some areas of news that is in from the Spanish sector. You know, because sometimes you get some, like, real good news from some Spanish websites. You know, we're just going to have to translate. And this particular news was found in the South American news outlets. Not by one, but by two or three of them, as a matter of fact. It's just that I couldn't cross-fact check it with NBC, with CBS, with no any of these mainstream liberal channels. Nothing. Zip. Nada. Silch. So it's really difficult, you know, for me to, but at least I'm mentioning, I'm making it known now. And this was happening. This was going, this was where me and Hector came to the conclusion. We don't think that he broke his foot at all. Nope. Not according to some of the things we came across. According to some of the things that we came across, Joe Biden, and let me repeat again, okay, this is a unconfirmed news story by the mainstream media. It's confirmed by some of the Spanish website medias from South America, but it's not, you know, at the moment confirmed by the mainstream media or by the newspaper like the New York Times or the Washington Post or the Daily News or any of these U.S. news and whatnot. So I just want to make that very clear. But me and Hector have come to the conclusion that there's a possibility that Biden got arrested. That's right. It's shocking, right? I know your jaw probably went dumb. Because I did the same thing, man. I did the same thing. I'm like going nuts over here. I said, what? Are you kidding me? Let me double check this again. And you guys probably wondering, I'm going to leave a link, at least one link, in the description section so you guys can check it out yourself. And but yeah, we believe that Joe Biden got arrested, and what he really has in that boot of his is a GPS ankle bracelet. We believe that Joe Biden, and not only Joe Biden, here's the next story. The CIA director. Have any of you guys heard anything about she dying this past weekend, as a matter of fact? Some said at her house, and some news website says in Europe. That's what they say. But according to our sources, we believe that the CIA director, Haspel, got arrested as well and charged with treason. Also charged with election fraud, masterminding the election fraud that allegedly took place. Not only that, but they also went to say that Obama was part of that arrest as well. So these three individuals, according again, I want to emphasize to these news outlets, have gotten arrested for mail fraud, election fraud, treason, and God knows what else. Not only that, a couple of CIA workers were found dead somewhere out in Europe. Some believe in the French mountains, in the French slopes, but that's what they believe. Like I said, I'm going to leave a link down in the description so you can listen to at least this particular news website and check it out for yourself. Because listen, there's a lot of noise out there, and I understand that some of you guys out there are not, you know, too happy about what's going on, you know. And I'm not happy either. I'm not happy either. But I'm not happy not because Trump didn't win. I'm not happy because Joe Biden didn't win. I am not happy because the world is watching, my friends. And right now, we are the laughing stock of the world. Do you know that these machines, the company that manufactures, administers, and sells these Dominion machines are from Canada? Now listen to this. They are not only from Canada, but they don't use those machines in Canada's election at all. They don't use the Dominion machines at all because they are very accessible to manipulation. Yes. Not only that, you can actually attach these Dominion machines to the internet. This is facts now. This particular subject is facts. A computer genius or expert has testified in three different states so far, in Arizona, Pennsylvania, and I believe that Nevada. I'm not quite sure about that particular one, but I know there's been three states so far. I got my notes here. I should look at my notes here, but I want to like fly through here. I'm trying to chop this up, you know, as quick as I can, because I got to stop making these long videos. You know, I don't want to like bore anybody, but this is some serious allegation, you know, election fraud. And if you look at the charts, if some of you have actually, well, obviously I'm not only talking to Republicans, but I'm also talking to Democrats. And I like to think that all of you listeners out there and viewers are open-minded to different news sources. I like to think that you are open-minded to possibilities, that you can listen at two different sides of the story and make a decision based on what you hear. So, but if you look at the charts that have been already pulled from some of these Dominion machines, take Wisconsin for example. The chart goes up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. Some for Biden, some for Trump, some votes for Biden, some votes for Trump. And then at 3 o'clock in the morning, they decided that they were going to shut down. This happened in Wisconsin. Now, Did they decide to shut down because Trump was like 150,000 votes ahead? I don't know. Maybe. And I'm going to tell you why. Because all through the day, you see the charts in the Dominion, Trump, Biden, Trump, Biden. And at 3 o'clock in the morning when they shut down, 10 minutes into this so-called shutdown, there was a big dump, something close to 300,000 ballots. Woo! And the chart went like that. So you have like a small percentage here of people, and then at 3 o'clock in the morning, whoop! Somebody made a big dump of ballots at 3 o'clock in the morning, because you're just not going to believe that at that particular time span, somebody can actually, I mean, it's mind-boggling. It's really mind-boggling. We're talking about thousands and thousands and thousands of votes, of ballots, rather, being dumped in Wisconsin. This not only happened in Wisconsin, but it also happened in Pennsylvania with charts. Rudolph Giuliani has showed it in these hearings that have been taking place in these respective states. Even the president, Donald Trump, had a press conference 2 days ago, which it was shocking because the mainstream media did not run it. I don't know. You know, this president. I've never seen nothing like it. I mean, you gotta tell it like it is, man. And I gotta tell it like it is, man. But I've never seen anybody get disrespected. I've never seen a president get disrespected the way this president has gotten disrespected in the last 4 years, man. It is unbelievable and uncalled for. And uncalled for. And like I said, I have said it many times previously, I'm not a big fan of Donald Trump's demeanor, personality. But he's made some promises before he won the presidency. And my friends, he has kept about 90% of them. 90%. Which usually these politicians don't keep nothing. Don't keep no promises, period. This guy has at least made 90% of what he promised to the American people. And I like him because of that. You know, I'm not going to lie. I'm not a big fan of political correctness. I had enough of that. We already had a smooth talker in the White House. His name is Barack Obama. You can see him in the picture here. One of the smoothest, most articulate speaking president in our history. But please, someone tell me, what did this man do for the country? What did he do during those 8 years for our country? I'm going to tell you what he did. I'm going to tell you what he did. During his presidency, SEAL Team 6, the team that allegedly killed, well, it's not allegedly, some people have confirmed this, the mainstream media has confirmed that SEAL Team 6 killed Bin Laden. Right? You guys remember that? Well, They were actually sent on another operation about 6 months later, and they ended up crashing their helicopter in the desert, killing all 20 plus of these young men. And I find that very, very, very strange. And the reason I find that very, very strange is because when the mainstream media said that Bin Laden's body was dumped at sea, come on, man. I just can't buy that. I just can't buy that. Ain't no way in hell you're going to call Bin Laden's parents or Bin Laden's family, which they all happen to be Muslims, to come and get the body, and they're going to say something like, don't worry about it, we don't want the body, dump it at sea. That's what they said. That's exactly what they said, and that's exactly what the government did. Dumped the body at sea. And I'm sorry, man, but I find that so hard to believe that we don't even have a photo of this man being dead, which is something that the government, that the CIA or the FBI or the government in general does to erase any doubt that anyone might have. Take Che Guevara, for example. When they killed him in South America, the first thing they did was they placed his body on a rock, and they allowed the press to come, and photographers and paparazzis, anybody who wanted to come and take pictures, they took pictures. They took pictures. Malcolm X, they took pictures. Martin Luther King, they took pictures. When you kill someone as important as Bin Laden, you're going to take a few pictures. Just to kill any doubt that might come, or rather, you know, arise from this situation. I would, but no. Nobody took any pictures. Now, I have said in some of my previous show that in some of my research, I found out that Bin Laden was, and probably still is, a CIA agent for many, many, many years. If you do some research, I'm sure you can find it. I'm not going to leave a link because this is not really the topic for today. I'm just happen to be mentioning it because this is in the kind of world that we live in. This is the kind of power that these socialist Democrats, these radical, radical socialist Democrats want, so they can implement this new world order that they've been wanting to implement now since the early 70s. Yes, it's been that long. Since the early 70s. Since they introduced electronic, what a coincidence, right? Since they introduced electronic ballot machines for future elections. That's right. Ain't that something? And if you notice, every single president from Jimmy Carter till now, with probably the exception of Ronald Reagan. And the reason I say probably the exception of Ronald Reagan, because as a lot of people my age know, Ronald Reagan was a cowboy. And he didn't take smack from no one. He did it like Frank Sinatra said. He did it his way. Till they tried to kill him and got shot. You guys remember that, right? Thank God that God saved his life, because he turned out to be an excellent president for our country at that time. Now, that doesn't take the fact that he could have probably been a Mason or Jesuit or an Illuminati, you know, but I think he was more of a Mason. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that he was. Now, but I need you guys to understand that there's people in the political process of our country that are globalist, and some are nationalist. Trump happens to be a nationalist. Now, that doesn't take the fact away. That doesn't take away the fact, rather, that he might be a Mason. You just never know. Or, in what I really think, a Jesuit, because he ended up going to Fordham University. That's probably one of the reasons one of the reasons why he kept Fauci, Dr. Fauci, around so long, because Fauci happens to be also a Jesuit from Fordham University. Yeah. But a lot of these guys, listen, this is what I study, you know, world affairs, sociology, and topics of that nature, international politics. And right now, in the 21st century, there's not one leader. Oh, well, maybe Maduro. But there's not one leader in these important countries like Australia, Germany, Italy, France, Greece, England, China, Japan, Korea. I believe there's not one leader in any of these countries that are not either part of the Mason family or part of the Illuminati or part of the Jesuits. Because, you know, unfortunately, that's how the cookie crumbles. I know that we all believe that we have the power to elect a president. And we do. But not how you think, how you guys think we do. Because the 13 banking families that run the world, you know, the Rothschilds, the Rockefellers, the Vanderbilts, the Morgans, 13 banking families. Had the list on here somewhere anyway. These people are the ones that select. Let me say that again. These people, these elite, these billionaires that run the world are the ones that select the people that are going to be running for the presidency of the United States. They even have influence in some of the Senate elections. But mainly the presidency of the United States is one that they control 1,000%. So they select those people, those 17 people that ran in the primary, 16 actually, those 16 people that ran in the primary of the Republican primary against Donald Trump. Or else, they couldn't run unless they had the blessing from these elite families that run the world. And that's just the way it is, whether you want to believe this or not. You know, they believe that in the world, there's got to be order. They like it to be one world order. You know, if possible. But as of now, it hasn't happened yet. You know what I just said, right? It hasn't happened yet. But it will happen. There's no doubt about that. You know, unfortunately, there's a secret government called the Deep State that run not only the affairs of the government or the affairs of the country, of our country in this part of the world, but also the affairs of every other country. And I know this is hard for some of you guys to swallow, because this is not the kind of stuff they teach in school. It's just not. Unfortunately, it's just not, and it should be part of the curriculum, if you ask me. You know, why not? I think that the powers that be could have an easier time implementing a one world order if they, how you say, come clean a little. You see, but that's where the problem lays. They can't come clean. For them to come clean would mean for them to tell the truth. And these people are not truth tellers. These people work for the prince of the air, for the prince of this world, for the prince of darkness, for Shaitan, and he's the father of all lies. And that's just the way it is. As a matter of fact, if you were to check the bloodline of all the presidents of the United States, you can actually see that I believe the last time I checked was 98% of all the presidents that have been, well, presidents in the United States are somehow related by blood. Did you guys know that Bush and Obama are long cousins? Yeah, even Obama was shocked to know that. But I'm sure he knew. And that's just the way things are. Or do you really believe that? Let's take this sucker that I don't like, Bill Gates, for example. Do you guys really believe that Bill Gates is smarter than you? Or smarter than me? Or smarter than anybody else, for that matter? Because he's a multi-billionaire, and he came up with Microsoft, and he came up with all of these programs for computers that Apple was making and other companies were making called Windows. But the thing is that the person that actually leveraged him to start Microsoft was one of the head honchos of IBM. That's right. Not only that, but Bill Gates' parents are connected either by blood, by family, by work assignment, by an oath, but yeah, they very, very well connected, and that's how young Bill Gates got his start. That's how Bill Gates now is running everything and anything that's got to do with vaccines. He had this love affair with vaccines. Think about that for a minute. Why? Who made him an expert on vaccines? I think it's a fair question if you ask me. It's unfortunate that we live in this kind of world, and to some people it might be shocking to the point where, you know, you people just don't want to believe it. They just rather live a lie, continue to live a lie and believe it. That's how come sometimes I be, you know, it shocks me. You know, it shocks me that I give some of my viewers and listeners like real facts, especially on Facebook, like facts, like real tangible facts. You know, I even send them a link and everything, and they still go against the truth. Because they just don't want to either accept it, or they're so programmed that they are incapable of accepting it. And it's really, really a shame that there's some people out there that they just don't see it. Like someone among you know that if we all unite, the government can't touch us. If we all unite, that censoring that these social media companies are getting away with won't be happening. That's why they take advantage of it, because right now we are split up because of quote unquote systemic racism. That's what the mainstream been pushing for the last 4 years since Trump came on board. Systemic racism. Mm-hmm. Really. My friends, this is by far still the greatest country in the world. Still. And I just hope that our president, Donald J. Trump, don't give up and puts up a good fight for the truth. A good fight for the truth. Because I believe that the truth, if you really embrace it, if you really embrace the truth, will set you free. Not only your mind, but your spirit. If you ask me, if you guys were to ask me, Yancy, what do you think about the election? What do you think is going to happen? Honestly, I believe that come Inauguration Day, Trump's still going to be the president. Yeah. He's still going to be the president. Because if there's anyone stubborn as hell when it comes to the truth and to the American way and to our Constitution, protecting the Constitution and our civil liberties, I don't think there's no one better or stronger than our President Donald J. Trump. Now, in the meantime, I'm going to continue to look, see what's the deal with the CIA director, Barack Obama, and Joe Biden. We already know the deal with Joe Biden. And that is just too much of a coincidence. Too much of a coincidence. A lot of you guys don't know that McCain got arrested for treason. You guys don't, a lot of you don't know, and I haven't even talked about it because I know there's some among you that are not going to believe me. But he got arrested for treason. And to save his good name, they made a deal with him. And they killed him with lethal injection. That's why when they were doing the funeral or they were having a mass at church for him, you saw the American flag on top of the coffin was wrinkled, which people in the military know what that means. That means that the person in the coffin is a traitor. That's what it means. When the flag is wrinkled, you can go back to the church or to the day that happened and you can find out. All of a sudden he developed brain cancer and whatnot, but that's not what really happened. That's not what really happened. He was charged. He was trialed by a military court. And he was sentenced to death. Hard to believe, right? But it is. And he's not the only one, by the way. There's been a few underlings, little guys. But there's a lot more to come. There's a lot more to come. That's why I still believe that Epstein is alive. That's why I still believe that he's alive. I still believe that he's back at his island. I still believe that he made a deal with the military district attorney, because you see these investigations of treason that is going on in our country is a military operation. This is not a DOJ or an FBI or a CI. No. They're all in the game. They're all part of the deep state. All of them. You heard William Barr the other day. Oh, there's no proof of mass voter fraud in these elections. Are you kidding me? Who the hell are you trying to kid, man? No evidence whatsoever? Come on, you know, to me, that's a smack in the face. That's a smack in the face. Because Giuliani, in the hearing that took place in Pennsylvania, he showed a stack of affidavits, signed affidavit at that, like this. And I'm talking about close to 2,000 to 3,000 people from around the country that took part in these elections. They have under oath swear that these things took place. And we're going to get to the bottom of it. Some of these states hasn't even certified. So I'm sorry to tell you, Joe Biden is not even president-elect yet. And it's like the president said, who said that the elections runs for 3, 4, 5 days or even weeks? That's never happened in this country. The election is one day. One day, all the states have to certify. And the next day, or even that same night, we already know who the president-elect is. But these people still, they're still counting ballots. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? There's a truck. A truck. I'm not lying, man. You guys gonna enjoy this one. Let me see if I can find it. But there's a truck. It's somewhere in my iPad here. Let me see if I can find it for you guys. There it is. Check it out. Look. This, look what it says in the back, right here. Biden campaign. And what is that? United States Postal Services. What is a private company or private car or private citizen doing with mail ballots inside boxes of the United States Postal Service? That's mail fraud, my friends. And that's not the only joke. There's another one in the front. Full of ballots. Where are they going? I don't know. But look, they're right there. But yet they claim that there's no evidence of fraud. This right here, my friend, is super illegal. That's why I believe that Joe Biden has a GPS on his leg and not a broken bone, like they say. And that Haspel is somewhere in prison. And Obama as well. Now, I could be wrong, because like I said from the very beginning of my show, I haven't been able to confirm this with either newspapers or news sources from the United States. I was only able to confirm it with website news outlets from Spanish country, like Brazil or in Colombia, and for some reason they get like real good news that we don't. As a matter of fact, in Colombia, was the Colombian news people was some of the first people that came out saying that that COVID-19, you know, based on a test from Italy, scientific test, that COVID-19 is not really a virus, it's a bacteria. Yeah. That's what they said, man. That's what they said. And when I checked with, when I cross-referenced with the university who actually did the report and the testing, when I cross-checked it, it was facts. It was the truth. They claim that it was a very, very dangerous bacteria that attacks the body, especially when you have secondary ailments, or secondary health issues. That's why most of the people, as a matter of fact, the CDC said this not too long ago, about a month ago, said that 94% of the people that have died in the United States of COVID-19 has some type of secondary health issue, some type. Either cancer, either Hep C, either high blood pressure, either problems with the heart, bad cholesterol, diabetes, lupus. Forget it. 94% has secondary health issues, according to the CDC. I spoke about this on one of my shows. But I'm going to leave a link below so you guys can check it out yourself. You know, and let me know what you think in the comment section. I hope that you like this content. Please share with others. Don't forget to smash the like button. I'm going to appreciate it very much. And also, don't forget that you can get my first single, Suwawanko, a tribute song to one of the best, if not the best, composers, poets Puerto Rico has ever had, Catalino Titecure Alonso. You can find my new song, my new production in CD Baby and other social media platforms. My name is Gian Ciodani for New York Real Life. Till next time. And don't forget, smash that like button. Ciao. I love you all.